So we were discussing 2016 paper part 2, discussing question number 1, right? Okay, so now we are about to discuss part 5, right? You can always use chat to share your answer. Now you have already done this, so you can always share your answer before I discuss the answer. So let's start. The fifth one, first column, we want to match with the second column. So the activity A, selecting a menu option using an optical mouse. Optical mouse. So mouse can be connected using at least 2 ports we have discussed, right? Remember the 2? What do you think? Mouse can be connected to what? What are the ports that we can use to connect? What are the ports that we can use to connect mouse? Yes, Achira? Achira, can you hear me? Vinu, what do you think? What are the ports that we can use to connect a mouse? Yes, exactly. We can use both USB and PS2. Pramudi gave me the correct answer. So answer for this one is we can use to connect this one with the USB, isn't it? So in this particular case, it's USB. Then B, listening to song using a headphone. So usually headphones are connected to audio port. So that's the second one. Third one, accessing the internet to local area network, that is network port. So we will use RJ45, so that is the network port that we will have. Show video clip using multimedia projector. Now we will have HDMI port. So the answers for this question is 2016 O-level examination, first question, part 5. A, USB, B, audio port, C, RJ45, D, HDMI. Right, good. Remember now, when I ask a question, try to answer in the chat. So it always reminds you what you have learned so far. At the same time, if there were any mistakes, I can correct it for you. So don't, you know, shy to share your answer. Don't worry whether it's right or wrong, because it'll take time, right? But only thing is, you should try harder. Okay, let's go for the next one. This is question number part 6. A document was created using word processing software and was formatted as indicated by number 1 to number 4, right? So we have given before formatting and after formatting, and we have given word processing software links from A to N. We are supposed to now find it. Can you quickly give me the answers? What you have selected? Okay, first one, we have 1. Yes, what is 1? We have Green IT. What you can see about Green IT, right? It's the size, isn't it? The size of the font. So if you look at the size of the font, you can either use B or C. C is increased font. Both are possible. So the answer for the first one is B or C. If you have given 1, is enough. Okay, only Pramodi answered that before I gave you the answer. Okay, Achira, Amasha, Binu, I want you to try harder for the next one. So we have Green IT. The 2, what has happened? Yes, of course. So it's bold. Bold means this should be, yes, tool number, yes, H. Right, now this time I got answers from Amasha, Pramodi, Binu. Achira, I think you better answer because there's no point of just waiting. So I want you to answer the questions, right? Most of you have submitted me the answers for the part two. Okay, let's move on to the third one. Now, third one, we have product longevity and materials recycling. So that actually we have lists. It's two kinds. We have bulleted list and we have numbered list. And what we have is bulleted leads. So that means it's F. So three should be F. Right. Okay, let's next one. Right, we have a link, right? And link is, slanted a little bit, right? So which means italics. So that italics is represented with I, the same letter. So we can put I. Okay. That's good. So except Achira, all the others have actively participated. I'll appreciate. And I hope Achira will share his answers at least from next. Okay. So we'll move to seventh one, part seven. Again, we want to select the values. We have P, Q, R, S, one side, right? It's about internet. And then we have the columns with values, HTTP, DNS, FTP, and WWW, right? So let's start with the P, large collection of electronic documents. Okay, so in the internet, right? So what is it? Which one, consists of the electronic documents? Definitely we know it's World Wide Web. So World Wide Web is a part of the internet, isn't it? And it's a place where all the electronic documents are kept. So all the web pages that we visit are kept in World Wide Web. So the answer for the first one is this should be mapped to World Wide Web. Q. Transfer large files from one computer to another over internet. So when you want to send files from one per computer to another computer, especially when you have large files, you know that you can't send large files in an email, you know that. And at least you have to use maybe a Google Drive, right? And the possibility is we can use file transfer protocol. So FTP stands for file transfer protocol. If you do not know, please take down the name. So you should know FTP stands for file transfer protocol. Okay, so that's Q. Let's move on to R then. Okay, translates a URL to IP address. Remember the URL is, for example, let's say www.divina.com, which means URL, and URL for humans. But you know, computers interact with each other using binary representation, which means we need to wait to identify each of these in the internet. Now for that, we are using domain name system, right? Or in say DNS, which will take the URL and it gives us the domain name system. Finally, a protocol to access web pages. Now we have already discussed sending files. We have files transfer protocol. Likewise, if you want to access the web pages, then you should access to this HTTP. Okay, so that's about the seventh one. I got correct answers from Amasha, Pramodi. Okay, this time Achira, good. We have Binu as well. Okay, so I think it's really good that you are trying to answer. At least try to answer before me, because that's your try. Don't worry about making mistakes, right? So if you are worried about making mistake, definitely you are going to be in trouble in the exam, right? So right now we are safe. Okay, last one from eighth one. Consider the following table with the image editing. Okay, and we have W to C in the first column. We have 1 to 4 in the second column. We want to match. First one, selecting a part of the image based on its color. Right? So what is the tool is called? In Photoshop, we said magic wand, but I think this is fuzzy select, right? You can check the book and tell me. So this is based on the color we are going to select. Then moving a selected part of the image, moving. So moving for move is the first one. So this is the icon for movie. Then erase part of the image, eraser, right? So we can say the second one is the answer. And the last one, yes, change the color of the selected part, paint bucket or bucket fill. We used to say bucket fill or paint bucket. So here are the answers. So the answers are W4, X1, Y2, and Z3. Yes, I got correct answers from Achira, Amasha, Pramodi, okay, Binu. Good. Let's move to the next one. Consider the given diagram. Give example for hardware, application software, and liveware. Okay, give me an example. Yes, what are the answers? What are the answers for hardware? Each of you should give me an answer. Hardware, you should know. Then application software. Each one should give us a unique value for each of these. Liveware. Yes, Pramodi said keyboard. Yes, we have keyboard. Okay, Amasha, can you give me something else? Okay, Pramodi said application software. Now for that spreadsheet. Or you can say Excel. Okay, Binu said, Achira said mouse. So, Binu, can you give me something else? Said mouse. Okay, we have keyboard, mouse. I mean, there are plenty of other things. Please hurry up. Yes, projector, good, Binu. Asha, can you give us hardware? About the liveware, liveware means what? You have a hardware, software, and liveware. Can you give me an example for liveware? Yes, Amasha said monitor. That's good. Okay. Application softwares. What are the other things? Word, Excel, PowerPoint. What else? Pramudit said Now, liveware means users, software engineer. Okay, here we have Amasha said computer games. Is that correct? A person, please. Yes. Come on, come on, come on. Pramodhi said one live, yeah. Amasha? Live, yeah, please. Yes, yes, come on, come on, come on. Achira? Live, yeah. A user. Give me a user. Somebody who uses computer. Live, yeah. Okay, only Pramodhi answered. Please hurry up, hurry up. If you do not remember, you can at least refer your textbooks. Yes, there are too many things you can. You can even say teacher, right? Student, web developer, whatever, right? Now Achira said web developer. Student, teacher. You can say anything you want, right? And here application software, we can say spreadsheet, Word, browser. Even the browser is a application software. I think you should not struggle. I mean, like when you have a, you know, question like this. Right, part B. Part B, identify and write down one component
represent by x,
one component. There are three things we talk about here, right? Right, what x, what is x, right? Come on, what is x? Achira, what is x? Yes, it's system software. And what are the components we have? Yes, operating systems. Utility software. Software. And then language translators. Okay. Remember, very important. This is grade 10, right? You should know these things. Okay, that was a good question, actually. Yeah. Right. Okay, good. Anyway, good that you are trying to answer, right? I want everyone to actively participate, because exams, you are getting similar questions. What I have observed, witnessed over the past couple of years, I have been now doing this is for, this is I think from 2010, I've been doing this. 2010, where I have started. So this is the 11th year. And what I have observed is questions are quite similar. Only thing is you need to have practice. You should work hard. Without working hard, don't expect that you can get an A, right? If you expect to get an A for this subject, you have to work hard. You have to send me the answers before the class. Then only you know like what you don't know, right? You know what you don't know, right? Once you have done a paper, you know what you don't know. So that is the place where you can improve. That part, I cannot, you know, help. It's up to you, right? So part of this contribution comes from me. So I should cover all the theory. I should cover the any practicals. Maybe do give enough, questions. And then as a student, you are supposed to work. Okay. Anyway, right. So let's move to the next one then. Okay, good one. Consider the following program segment in Pascal. We have an array. An array starts with 0 to 4. Right? 0 to 4. You remember the arrays, right? What is an array? Array, usually we will get a single name, like in this particular case, we said num. And then we create multiple locations, isn't it? I told you, array contains multiple locations. How many locations? Now it depends on, the indexes that you keep. Now here we have 0, because since you are giving a single name for multiple values, this index, will help us to select which one that we are actually referring here, right? So we have 0, we have 1, then we have 2, right? Then we have 3, and then we have 4. So it's like this. Okay, right. Now this is what we have. Now the question is the output, right? But before that, we have some assignment. Right? Can you fill these places? When you say num 0, for example, this one, right, in this location, is the num 0. Then this is num 1, num 2, num 3, num 4. Right? Maybe I will type it here, num 4. So this is num 4. A question asks, right? First of all, we can make the assumptions, like we can assign the values. What are the values? Let's start. try to put the values. And can you tell me what are the values here? Can you type? පිළිවෙලට පුතේ මට එවන්න. බිංදුවේද කීයද එන්නේ? එකේද කීයද එන්නේ? දෙකේද කීයද එන්නේ? තුනේද කීයද එන්නේ? හතරේද කීයද එන්නේ? අන්න ඒ වගේ. මට කමා සෙපරේට් කරලා අගයන් ටික කියවන්න මේකේ මේකේ ෆිල් වෙන අගයන් ටික. I will give you 1 minute. So what are arrays? Arrays are single named entities where we can store multiple items. So we will give a single name, num, right? And the index is the numerical value we use to, you know, select individual elements. So the first one we can select as num 0. So the second one num 1, third one num 2. Fourth one num 3, fifth one num 4. Right, Pramodi gave me the answers. How about the others? Amasha, Binu, Achira, give me the answers. Come on, come on. Okay, let me help you. First one, num 0 is 15, so that means this is 15. First one 15. Right, then let's look at num 2 is 18. Num 2 here, it's 18. Then num 4 50. Num 4 50. This is 50. Right, then num 1 is num 4 plus 10. Num 1 is num 4. Num 4 is 50 plus 10, that is 60. So this one is 60. Then num 3 is 0 plus 2. 0 plus 2. So that means 33. So here are the values. Here are the values. So 15, 60, 18, 33, and then we have 50. Now, this is what has happened. We have done up to this. This is a for loop. Can somebody tell me what will happen inside the for loop? Yes. It's a for loop. A for loop එකේ මොකද වෙන්නේ? එකේ ඉඳන් හතරට යන්නේ. හරි? එකේ ඉඳන් හතරට. එහෙනම් print කරන්න ඕන numbers කී ඉඳන් කී වෙනකන්ද? පළවෙනි සැරේ i 1යි. එහෙනම් මොකද print වෙන්න ඕනේ? num 1 කියන එක. දෙවෙනි සැරේ print වෙන්න ඕනේ i 2යි num 2 කියන එක. තුන්වෙනි සැරේ print වෙන්න ඕනේ i 3යි ඒකේ num 3. final one අන්තිමික num 4. 1 2 3 4. num 1 we know 60, so the final answer is the final answer. first one we have to have num 60, so num 1, that is 60. Then num 2, that is 80. Then 33. Then 50. So this is the answer. Right? Okay. Can you raise your hands if you have got the correct answer for this one when you do the your exercise? Okay, I'll start from the beginning. So when you say num array 0 to 4 means you create an array called num. Index grows from 0 to 4, which means you can store 5 numbers, num 0, num 1, num 2, num 3, num 4. The era the assignment, we have first one 15, then third one 18, fifth one 50. The first one, fourth one plus 10. So we have 60. Then 0 plus 2. That is 33, right? And finally, we have 50. So here is the answer. So if you didn't do this, take down and make your own notes. So let's take down the notes. Right? What are the notes? I will put line numbers. This is line number one. Then begin line number two. Then 59 number, maybe I can reduce the size of this. We can have one, yes. Then begin number two, three, four, five, six, 7, 8, 9, last one 10. Right. So we can say line number one, create an array named num to hold 5 integers. The first number is num 0. Second number is num 1. The last number is num 3. Then line number 3, we can say num 0 is 50 assignment. line 4, likewise you can write down. Okay, then line 8, the loop shows content from num 1 to num 4. Line 9, the output is 60, that is number 1, then 18, number 2, 33, number 3, 50 is number 4. Right, so I have given you some explanation as well, how we could get the answer for this one. Right, okay. Finished? Let me know when you are finished. Second one, part one. Can you send me the answers, please? Yes, can you send me answers for question number 2, part 1? Right. So let's look at the answers. Second one, present itself as a harmless and enters without the knowledge of users and that could steal and or delete data. Looks as harmless. If you remember the things that we have discussed last time, we discussed this is a Trojan horse, right? So according to this, what we have given is spyware. So we can take it as a spyware. But actually it's a Trojan horse. B, collects information about bank account or electronic accounts using emails and steal cash deposit by deceiving the user. Okay, now normally what will happen in here, you will be presented as a online banking system, but it's a fake one. Usually it will come up with a fake one. It can ogollonge banku api online banking ka tibbana eka wageema ekak yewano email haraha thiyena awastha thiyeno link ekak widihata dena awastha thiyeno godak welata email saraha thamai me wenne ඉතින් අපි ක්ලික් කරපුවම අපේ බැංක් account එක වගේ තමයි පෙන්නන්නේ log වෙන interface එක පෙන්නනවා ඉතින් අපි හිතනවා නම් මේක බැංක් එකයි කියලා අපි වැරදිලාවත් enter කරොත් ඒවා ඒගොල්ලෝ ගන්නවා අරගෙන අපේ accounts වලට සම්බන්ධ වීම හැකියාව තියෙනවා ඉතින් මේකට අපි කියනවා phishing කියලා See, unauthorized email either relate to advertisement about a product or form or an unknown person collects email addresses and they are used unlawfully. When you create an email, you will see first few days you will not get any email at all. Neither email like a khadabuang kauru tapi email le wana nai ni. Samata tapi baling kyu othe me yalu ante wani kero nai wana natang email pavichu ni mane. ඒ වුණාට ඇඩ්වර්ටයිසින් කම්පැනිස් එහෙම මොකද කරන්නේ? අන්න යාළගේ ප්‍රොඩක්ට් එහෙම විකුණන ගන්නවා නේද? ඊමේල් එකතු කරනවා. හරි? එක දවසක් යනකොට අපිට කිසිම අදාළත්වයක් නැති ඊමේල් අපිට ලැබෙනවා. So those kind of a email we call spam. Spam emails. And in software we have spam filters which filter out emails for us. Okay? Final one. Are capable of acting and spreading along the email attachments, false website, and instance messages. So that is computer worm. That is the only remaining one. So the answers are A, spyware, Trojan horse, B, phishing, C, spam, D, computer worm. Okay, let's move the second question, part two. Write down two methods for proper disposal of electronic waste. There are three R's, right? What are the three R's? If you remember the three R's, there are three R's when it comes to, you know, disposal or recycling. There are three R's. Can you tell me? ආර අකුරු තුනක් තියෙනවා මේ වගේ වලදී. මොකද ආර අකුරු තුන? දැන කෙනෙක් කියන්න බල. Yes from the good. Reuse, reduce and recycle. Right? Reduce means do not use this electronic stuff, right? Electronic waste, computers do not use. Right, two methods, proper disposal. Disposal meaning reuse and recycle. So the answer for A is right, we can say reuse and then we can say recycle. So you can use it again and again, give it to somebody who will use it or recycle it. Right. B, write down any three recommended correct posture a user should adopt in order to minimize the adverse effects such as computer vision syndrome, carpal tunnel syndrome, and repetitive stress injury related to ICT. We know that correct posture is very, very important when you work with computers, right? So if you sit in front of a computer for longer period of time, if you are not maintaining a correct posture, so you might be in trouble, right? So what are the things you should do? Can you send me some answers that you have selected? Right. Prabhuti said eye level, very important. When you look at monitor, especially, you make sure that the monitor screen set at the eye level or slightly below that, not up, right? If you do not do that, you are getting headaches, you know, all the other issues. Binu said straight shoulders. Yes. Yes. Straight. Keep your legs vertically to ground. Yes. Yes, Achira, can you tell me one about Amasha? Yes. So the things that actually you can do, the correct posture, The correct posture should be there. I'm just checking where we I could find that the details. Some parts are missing in the English medium one, so I'm really okay. So these are the things that I want to discuss, right? I have not put this. So let's write down these things, right? Otherwise, you might miss. So let me convert and give it to you, right? So how do you, what posture you should use to minimize the issues? It asks only three, right? It asks only three, but let's write a couple of things. Right, let's write down. Right, I will put this is 2B, right? Adjust the computer screen to eye level or below. Then the distance between the computer screen and the eyes should be 18 to 28 inch. So that is 47 to 70 centimeters. Then keep your back straight. And shoulders in relaxed position. Keeps the legs perpendicular to the ground and the soles of the feet on the ground. Then adjust the light on the computer screen so that it does not for the eye. Then time to time look outside the computer screen. We will normally say 20-20 rule. I will explain what this is. Can you take down this one? Adjust the computer screen to eye level or below. The distance between the computer screen and the eyes, we have some distance. Keep your back straight and shoulders in a relaxed position. Keep the legs perpendicular to the ground and the soles of the feet on the ground. Adjust the light on the computer screen so that it does not bother eye. Remember, the monitor screen should be adjusted, especially in night. Daytime, it's okay. You might have like, you know, monitor where, you know, the light will, you know, affect your eyes' health. So you should, you know, control. Now, if you install like Windows 10 or 11, automatically it will adjust based on the computer time. But otherwise, you have to do it manually. And then final one, time to time, look outside. Look outside means 20-20 rule means every 20 minutes, you should at least see 20 meter distance for about 20 seconds. I will repeat, 20-20 rule means for every 20 minutes, you should look at a distance of 20 meters for 20 seconds, right? So that's what we call 20-20 rule. Right, okay, so that's part B. Right. Question number two, part 2C. Can you give an explanation for that? Shall we try? Right, answers for C. Okay, let's look at the answers. An information technology manager, IT manager of a company, is also an active member of a voluntary organization which supports families of low income for education, health care, etc. Without the knowledge of the authority of the company, he provides a list of email addresses of leading businessmen who are customers of his customer company to voluntary organization in order to contact them for fundraising. Briefly explain why the act of IT manager is unethical, right? So Pramodi said giving data to another company without the permission of his organization, right? Now usually, now this is what could happen. Now usually when we sometimes when we install software, they ask our email addresses and then we have to provide them when you're logging in and they can give it to somebody else. Now remember, now when they collect information, they usually say that these email addresses, our information, personal information, they are not going to share with anyone. But if they want to do it, either you have to get the permission. Now, in this particular case, it's the email addresses are collected by his company. So he has to get the authorization. So the answer is, right, you know, giving the data to a third party, another person, without the permission, which violates the agreements. So it's violating the privacy as well. So remember that. So that's why it's unethical. So you can write down providing confidential data to another person without proper permission from the organization. It violating the privacy. Okay, D, the computer hardware in an office are completely destroyed by a fire. And as a result, some important data in the storage devices have been lost forever. Briefly explain the precautionary steps that could have been taken to avoid the loss of data. Samahata meka wenna puluwan puthe gini gang wathura mena me wen api electronic upanga haani wenna puluwa ehema naththam me dawasala nan thundering neida akunu gahanawa. So that might affect the our you know may lost data in computers. So what are the precautionary api arakshita upakrama vidihata pavichchi karanna puluwam monawada? Yes, any ideas please? Precautions. Yes, first one, you can keep backups. Pramodi said keeping backup good. Backing up data is very, very important. And not only backup, if you take the backup and if you are keeping the same place, will that be a good idea? No, right? When you're keeping backup, make sure that you keep it somewhere else. Normally, if you have a large organization, they have keeping their backups in different places. Because if one place, if something happens for one place, right, the data is available in other locations. And nowadays we have this Dropbox, Google Drive, like cloud-based services. So we can use cloud-based service for this. So the answers are, you can say keeping the backup and keep it in different places. And backup in cloud storage, right? So those are taken as the answers for part D. Right. Question number three. Right. Can you quickly give me that answer? So we have A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. Can you give me the answer for this? Right. Let's start. In addition to an internet connection, a space is an essential component to publish a website. Now, to publish a website, what do you need? Yes. What do you need? You need web host. So the answer for the first one is web host. Why web host? Now, web host is the place where you are going to keep your data. Very important. Without a web host, you cannot keep, right, a copy somewhere else. You cannot publish a website without web host. Good. D, space is used in creating dynamic websites. Yes. How do you create dynamic? Dynamic means what? Contents may change. Yes, B. Yes, B should be content management software. If you remember CMS, I told you like so it's content management software. So basically, it will handle all the data in a one single place. C, text, images, and sound are components of what? Yes, web content. Web content means you can have text, you can have images, you can have videos. We have learned some of them, right? So that could be also used to find out this. Right, D, regular updating of a website is an important part of what is maintenance. Right. So we can say this is web content. Content means whatever we are going to have it. We can have text, we can have images, animations, and so on. And then regular update, we can say maintenance. So we can say maintenance. So the answers are, yes, we can say A, web host, B, content management software. We can say web content, the so we can have maintenance. Okay, so those are the answers. Right, so let's move on to bit easy one, I guess. Why I said easy one? So we have this and we have the HTML code for this. I want you to identify first one, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, sixth one, seventh one, eighth one. Yes, can you give me the first one? Answer for the first one. Yes, exactly. So after head, one should be title, right? Good. Right. What is the second one? So you have to use these labels. These are the what we have. So what is two? Second one, two. It should be a header. And look at the code. Headers we discussed, there are six headers starting from H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. And then what we have here is H2, right? So the second one is H2. Third one. So there's a small mistake here when we have two and three, you don't see because we have only human conflict. So in that exam, right, for both two, three, they accepted H2, right? For example, somebody might think it's a bold. No, automatically it's bold when you say a header. So the third one, in the exam, they have taken as H2. So either two or three, if you ever have H2, they have given the marks, right? So I'm going to say 2, 3, both as H2. But I think you don't need anything in third one. You can remove third one without affecting this. You don't have to type H2 twice. Then fourth one, it's an easy one. Fourth one. Yes, what is fourth one? Fourth one. Yes, exactly. Font. Yes. Font. Right, we'd say we are changing the font face, Arial, size is 2. Fifth one. Yes, fifth one. If you look at the fifth one, yes, what can you tell about the fifth one? Yes, IMG and then what? Source, right? SRC. So the fourth one should be SRC. SRC means source. Okay, then sixth one is the easy one. Sixth one. Paragraphs. Seventh one. Yes, alignment. Look at the alignment. Both ends are, you know, aligned properly. So which means this could be the justify. And finally, eighth one. Yes. HR hyperreference, HREF. So that was the easy one, I think. There were sometimes the issues in the questions, but generally you can score. It's a good one. Question number four. Right, question number four. We have average monthly price, 1 kilo of a tea price, start from 2014 December to 2015. That's average price. Right? The formula of the form in B16. To get the average tea price of year 2015. Year 2015. So how do you start? So what we need is answer here. 2015 means we have to get the average value of all these except the first line. Yes. So what are the answers? First one. So what is the answer? Yes, we can either say average, we can say B4, right? B15. Right, or else if you go by the given function, we can say function 1 is average. Then cell 1. So that is B4. Then cell 2. B15. Right. Okay. And some of you have already typed the answers. So question number 2, part 2. Can you give me an answer for that? Price difference of month, average monthly price from the month of December is calculated as follows. December wala price ek difference ek ganna. Api December price ekin adu karana November price ek. A formula written in cell C15. Okay, C15. Okay, so here, what we needed it here, 50. Mono adhi liyan no ni kila haan. For 50. What do you have to do? 15 minus 14. That's all. So we can say, equals B4 minus B3. So if you copy C15 to C4, what is the outcome? Yes. Yes, we can say equal sign. Okay, so this one is wrong actually. Should be 15 to 40. This answer is incorrect, sorry. And here, we have to say B4 minus B3. So that was a mistake, sorry. Then fourth one, chart types. What kind of a charts we had to draw? Yes, Pramodi said we can have bar chart, line chart, column chart. Any of these will work. Last one, what cell range would you use for the horizontal axis to draw the charts in your answer for the fourth one above? What range of values you are going to select? So what are the x-axis you are going to use, the values, right? So we can say if you start from A, January to December, 4 to 15, right? So what? It lasts the range only, so we can say A4 to A15. A4 to A15. That's all. Right. There are two more questions to go, but I'm going to stop for today. And I'll be sharing another paper, right? Keep on doing the paper. So when you actually master multiple pages, we can go back. But for the time being, you should know, right? How to make use of this. And it was a good question actually, yes. Okay, so we'll stop for today. I'll be sending 2018 paper after this session. And I want everyone to at least try a couple of questions there as well. Okay, good night then. හොඳයි පුතේ එහෙනම් අපි නතර කරනවා. ඔයගොල්ලෝ හැමෝටම එහෙනම් සුබ රාත්‍රියක් නේද? ප්‍රාර්ථනා කරනවා පුතේ එහෙනම් පරිස්සමෙන් අපි ලබන සතිය හම්බෙමු.